Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, who will be the first e-sporter of Anderlecht. 109 years of football history. And the first candidate is Zakaria Bentato. Give it up for Zakaria, ladies and gentlemen. Good luck, my friend. And his opponent, the very feared Wesley Campana. Okay, give the handshake to each other, guys. Yes, we're online, we're on Twitch. Good luck, go for it. Have fun on the main stage.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for coming out once again here at the Constant Van den Stok Stadium, the home base of Royal Sporting Club Anderlecht, a historical team, a historical club. And they're about to write history once again as they will put pen to paper on a contract, contracting a FIFA player as one of the first Belgian clubs. Welcome back, yes. Chris. And we are looking forward to this
matchup. And welcome back to you, Rene. Oh, man, I'm really fired up for this one. Two great players, Zakaria Bentato, the Belgium champion of 2016.
Yeah, and Wesley Campana, not a lot of tournament experience, but he already managed to win a tournament, the FIFA Masters Cup this year.
Yeah.
And of course, he had 39 wins in the weekend league in June. 39 out of 40.
That's unbelievable.
So that's impressive.
Top 15 Europe. And Wesley Campana had got a great round of 16 against his opponent two times, 1-0, just one goal, but he just created three chances and scored directly. So it is a very big, it's very big danger for him, for Zakaria Bentato, to watch out the effectiveness of Wesley Campana. Campana went viral, though, because he plays also football on the real field. Scored a great goal for, I believe, SV Melda. And that goal went online, and Campana went viral. How good is that?
Definitely.
He plays for Exop.
Exop Gaming, yeah.
Do you know that team?
Small organization, up and coming, much like Wesley Campana, you could say. So they're a perfect match, I feel.
Right.
Although Wesley, if he puts it over the top at this tournament, if he proves himself here, he would be the perfect fit for Royal Sporting Club Anderlecht.
Yeah.
Because he's a swell guy, he's relaxed, he's social. And
very social.
Definitely.
But Zakaria also, he's now the flag carrier of Ego. Also a very relaxed guy, man.
Yeah.
He just has to wait it out in the sun.
Also very professional.
Yeah, he's very professional, very relaxed. He's very positive over his team. Ego, his guidance is very good. And he wants to be the first e-sporter of Anderlecht. I mean, that is the big prize. Of course, prize money. We got 1,000 euros of prize money. That's pretty big.
Yeah.
But the real title, of course, is being the first e-sporter.
That's it.
This
I could see both of these guys in an Anderlecht shirt.
Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely.
Both
absolutely.
Ultimate
Campana
professionals.
Also
very
representative. You know, Bentato, same for him as well.
Yeah. Nothing bad to say about these guys. And we talked about this before. We're going to see the Bayern München matchup. And it's going to be the home kit for Zakaria Bentato.
So he's playing the red.
Yeah, definitely. And the black shirts are for Wesley Campana, who is working in the pediatric industry.
Yeah, that's
working with children.
Yeah, that's
much
very
like
good,
you did
very
in
good.
The past yourself.
Yeah, absolutely. For 18 years with a lot of fun. But you know, sometimes your path changes. And I think we are away in the Allianz Arena. But of course, we're just here between the Constant Van der Stok Stadium, where there is a fan day, a beautiful fan day, loads of fans, and everything in the neighborhood is purple and white.
Yeah, exactly. But right now it's all about the red and black of Bayern Munich, as we see Zakaria Bentato, the champion of 2016, make his way towards the box of Wesley Campana. Slowly but surely, he gets his moves in. Nice play. Oh,
first
great
shot
right there. But that's smashed wide by, I hope, Manuel Neuer, and not again Ulreich.
Yeah, that was a curious mistake, wasn't
curious
it? Who did it already?
Mistake,
it was not Bentato.
It was Bentato.
Yeah, it was
Zakaria.
Bentato. Right. Yeah. But now we have here Wesley with Arturo Vidal, the guy from Chile. From that's a one big muscled guy, Vidal, and already gets the ball over the sideline, and then Zakaria wants to build up his second attack, but there is Wesley again. Wesley was also very, very good against his direct opponent in the previous round. Two times 1-0 against Matthias Mebe, who played pretty good with Juventus, actually.
Yeah. First time we've seen that.
Yeah, but still, Wesley was the better man. Zakaria now. No. Clean tackle over there. And now Wesley can build up this first attack. There's a lot of pressure now here from Zakaria. So Ribery takes some time. Oh, that's a nice through ball, is it? On Costa. Costa now for Wesley. Can he do something? No, he just walks the ball over. Oh, I thought it was over, but yeah. No, referee
not
said
all
it was
the way,
okay.
Apparently.
And now Zakaria is off.
There we go. Zakaria Bentata once again trying to get his moves flowing. He's already had one shot at the goal. Right now switching play all over with the cross pass towards the left flank. Playing in Thomas Müller, who plays in a midfield position. It seems no left wide striker. And then, of course, our very own Arjen Robben on the right flank. And your friend has passed it to the midfield. Arturo Vidal with a sloppy pass. And then Sanchez can't get to it. And right now Bentata needs to make a foul to keep things under control, and Wesley Campana can build up his attack.
And the circumstances for the players, we already mentioned it here. Yeah, you can't see it, of course, on the big screen, but playing here now on the main stage, seeing all those thousands of fans in the sun, sometimes a little bit of rain, then having have to sit on a pretty big chairs, sweaty hands, yeah. And the tension of have to perform and the pressure of doing that, so makes it very difficult. So it's pretty neat what these guys show us now. Maybe now a through ball on Lewandowski. No, Ribery was there in the center. Hasn't been reached. And now Wesley can build up, because we haven't seen a shot from Wesley. But the guy is very effective. Once he is through, he is dangerous. There was a little bit of a hole, but Zakaria closed the door.
Definitely, yeah. Talking about danger, Zakaria has had his fair share of perilous moments for his opponent.
Did he?
And yeah, especially... Let me see, he played Jeffrey Mago earlier today.
Yeah,
and we
did.
Saw that round of eight match,
yeah.
Live. We commentated it live. And despite having Ulrich in goal, he managed to close it out over two matches. He gave up the first goal, but yeah. Then he clawed his way back into the match. Especially the 2-0 win in the second one was very impressive. Yeah, of course, he scored with Renato Sanchez as well in the first match.
Yeah, and Renato Sanchez also delivered an assist. And now this is a nice through ball, but a little bit too hot. And Neuer came out of his goal. And if you look at the faces of the two players, they are very, very much in focus. And it really sounds like they're having fun, of course, but they know the interest of this very big game.
Yeah.
At this point, you just reach as a player a certain amount of focus that anything around you can happen, and you still just play your game, watch your opponent, and looking for opportunities. Now here, Wesley still tries it now on the left flank with Boateng.
Oh.
That is a good through ball. Lewandowski has been hammered off the ball by Alaba, the Swiss defender. Alaba, one of the better players here in the game. Oh, that's a nice skillful move of Robben. But there was the Campana moment.
Danger. Could have been a penalty, wouldn't you say?
No. It was not a foul at all. But at least I thought
it
that
was
way.
On the
and
ball,
the referee
yeah.
Did so too. And the referee is always right. At least my mother told me.
Right.
And you can do anything when the referee is not watching. But anyways, we're watching right now to Zakaria, who's taking more time in his offensive tactics. More passing, more short pass game. You see it now with Sanchez. Again, Sanchez, who's playing a very, very important role in the tactics. Lewandowski, Ribery!
There we go.
What a great goal! Franck Ribery puts it in the cross.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a nice
amazing
fake.
Amazing moves. It reminds you of
great the shot, though.
Yeah, look at that, Renato Sanchez. It reminds you of the earlier goal against, that was with Arjen Robben, but doesn't matter. Renato Sanchez pushed him through against Jeffrey Mago. And this time, once again, Zakaria Bentata shows why he is one of the favorites to win this tournament. And how come?
I just didn't see that coming, man. Just a little fake with Ribery and then up the shot.
Just after Campana was upping the pressure as well. But like you said, the stakes are high and the pressure is big. So both of these players are kind of nervous, but once they shake that off, these are class players. And oh, he shows it right now.
It is unbelievable.
The class is on display right here.
One shot, one opportunity, and then one goal. The Campana does it again. I'm just calling him the Campana. Look at that, outside right foot and then high. In the ropes. Oh, that is a beautiful strike.
Standing still in between three players. He just hammers it home. And what a campaign he's having, Campana.
With Lewandowski. That is beautiful. I think this is his sixth chance of the whole tournament.
Yeah.
And his fourth goal. It is unbelievable.
Yeah, he's
unbelievable.
A clinical finisher, that's
for sure.
Yeah,
it is. I mean, of course, in FIFA, this was a big chance, but you get bigger opportunities. And now you just got a little bit of space. And then, oh, the through ball is good in there, Lewandowski. Against Neuer. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Talking about a little bit of space.
Unbelievable. That ball just kept on rolling, didn't it?
Yeah, in between two defenders and just went right through the through ball, reaching its intended target, but just in time with the save, Manuel Neuer. He's going to have a hell of a day, Manuel Neuer, on both sides of the pitch, because Wesley Campana, once again, looking for the offense, trying to reach his strikers, and then finally loses possession on the back of some great defending by Zakaria Bentato, who loses it right here in midfield. The ego player fighting back, though. Of course, he's playing for the ego organization for almost a year now.
There's also a big confrontation now between ego and Exop, of course, this game. And you see at the gameplay that we've now reached the stage in the tournament where the stakes are so high.
Yeah.
Two beautiful goals. I think Zakaria Bentato was the dominant one.
Yeah. Most definitely.
On the grass.
We see it here, 63% possession.
Yeah, it's 62% possession of the ball. But still, those effectiveness of Wesley Campana, it sounds a bit Italian.
Yeah, it's a bit like the... It's not Catenaccio he's playing. Because
No, absolutely not.
Is firing on all cylinders when he goes for it on the offense. And he takes a lot of players on the half of his opponent. But you're right, he doesn't create a huge amount of chances. But whenever he creates them, he puts them away.
Yeah. And you can see that you're a top player, because when we predict such an outcome of the game and then you actually do it, I mean, that shows that you're great. 1-1 now in this second half. And of course, the hunt for the first e-sporter of Anderlecht and Belgium, at least in this games industry of FIFA 17. And we see a lot of youngsters, young fans of Anderlecht, walking their way around the stadium and looking to the presentation of the team. But they're pairing up now in front of the main stage, really living with the players, really are into the game. This beautiful, alive match now with a through ball. Yeah, of course, he tries it again. But now Wesley Campana shuts the door again.
Yeah, we haven't seen much play over the flanks. Once again, this is going right through the center. We haven't seen many crosses being hurled into the box. And it's all about the through pass right here. It's in FIFA 2017, we've seen that a lot. We've seen it with a lot of players. Usually a stacked midfield and two or three strikers up front. And right now, maybe some flank play with Arjen Robben, of course, there on the right flank. Usually he likes to come inside, shimmy past a few defenders and put it in the long corner. But right now it's Wesley Campana on the... Well, he loses it. So, once again, Zakaria Bentato, right now on the left flank, with some decent moves, but no danger just yet.
That word decent triggers me a bit. He's playing decent, right? Yeah. He's playing low risk, low key football. He wants to set up his attack pretty good. Doesn't want to make an error or a foul, as it seems. But that could be a risky tactic against the Campana, who has such little opportunity to be successful. But when he gets the opportunity, he usually strikes and hits the net. This is beautiful. Nice tiki-taka play. There comes the cross and the shot. Oh, that was very close. Just 1 yard, I guess, alongside the post. But he's fronting his eyebrows a little bit. Yeah, he's not too happy.
He's also not in the mode, in the position you would see a player in usually. He's sitting up front with the controller tied like
that. Back now, right?
Yeah. So, well, I hope he's not giving up on himself just yet. Because it's still one-to-one.
Players are up front yet.
Ah, there they are again.
And they play the same system. So that's four defensive players, two defensive midfielders, three offensive midfielders, and then one deep striker, you call it. Yeah.
Interesting. Let's see if it pays off right now. I feel like Zachary is squinting a bit with his eye, so he might have a little bit of sunlight in there, but...
Yeah,
gonna have to get used to it real soon, because there's no room for errors right now. It's bet big or go home. It's all or nothing.
Yeah,
backs against the wall, and Zachary is defending like a champion with his back against the wall. Once again, taking over possession, trying to weave his way through the midfield.
It's like a Caribbean stud poker, man. All or nothing, and the one who tries to take the chance usually gets it. But one error could be fatal in this Caribbean stud poker game, but it's FIFA 17, because we're now in the quarterfinals. Eight warriors are left, and one of the eight will be the first e-sporter of Anderlecht. 4.7 million players of FIFA 17. Oh, that's a good through ball now. Lewandowski gets the shot. Lewandowski, no. And the block there was pretty good. Pretty decent block there from Alaba. Corner kick now for Wesley.
Wesley looking comfortable right now.
Yeah, he is. Although, he is.
Just as I say that, that's the cast of Scurs right there. He gives up possession, and now Zakaria is looking for space. Oh, with a through ball from Arjen Robben, onto Lewandowski can't beat his marker just yet, but Renato Sanchez still in possession. Look at that, the Polish striker played in. Oh, it's actually Douglas Costa, and he loses it.
Yeah, and he did. Why just it just didn't went through? I mean, he just got a little bit of space, and Wesley Campana doesn't give a lot of space. And if you got the space from Wesley, you have to use it, and Zakaria just to hold it a little bit. Wants to play the passing game once more. Oh, cheeky backheel here to Robin, and again now the rebound. Now a long time ball possession for Zakaria. Can he do something with this? Now it is Renato Sanchez, the man of the assist. The assist is good.
Oh, the rebound, maybe.
Oh no, rebound! Oh, was it on the post or was it on Neuer in the short corner, as we call it, in the inside post? Man, that was a beautiful attack. This is the play of Zakaria Bentato when it works.
Definitely, yeah, but when it's working for Wesley Campana, it gets dangerous. Well, this time the through ball not quite reaching Lewandowski, and once again Neuer collects. And then a slow play by Zakaria Bentato to reach his midfielders, trying to look for some space. Clutch situation in midfield, 3 versus 4 actually, but still making it work somehow. Yeah. And on the lookout for a lone striker who might have enough space to make his way through. And interesting to see Arjen Robben playing in a midfield position.
Absolutely, he's playing behind Lewandowski. That is also one of the tactics of Zakaria Bentatu. Tries a nice skillful twist and turn move, but Wesley is focused, might lose the ball to Boateng, Jerome Boateng, and Vidal with a nice through ball again. Coman, Kingsley Coman turns it. On Sanchez and Robben, who bumped into one another. But still, the attack continues. Still in the goal.
Oh, there we go.
There it is.
Nailed it.
Arturo Vidal does it. This was huge pressure from Zakaria Bentato. 5 minutes ago, he created a beautiful chance. And now Vidal from the penalty spot from
definitely
11
yeah.
meters. He does it.
We've seen Vidal score a lot of goals in real life, of course, for Bayern Munich. A lot of long-distance shots.
Yeah.
But in FIFA, you don't usually see him on the scoreboard. But right now, even played into the box with a lot of neat combinations. And I can't say it's undeserved because, Zakaria is playing like a champion.
Yeah, he's playing really like a champion. But still, don't underestimate Wesley Campana. I mean, the man is on the move. That's and the man is on the hunt. But we have the 87th minute now counting. This is a crucial goal because 1-1 or 2-1 for Zakaria Bentato.
Yeah,
he just really raised his fist. Was really happy to clinch that goal. And now he has to take the ball in possession. Doesn't change his system and just go up front. That is nice from Bentato. Look at that back heel from Robben. Doesn't get the ball now. Kingsley Coman was very, very important now with this attack. Maybe this is the last chance for Campana in his first leg. Oh, this is nice play. But then he loses the ball. We are now in stoppage time. I think 1 minute. No, 2 minutes. 2 minutes stoppage time.
Look
Zakaria
at that.
Zakaria leads.
Through.
Oh, that's a nice cross. And the goal is there.
Oh, wow.
Kingsley Coman,
yes,
at
that.
He points it.
Look at him celebrating.
I knew this moment came. And again with Kingsley Coman, but this cross, that is
perfect. Pure
magic.
Pure
magic. This is beautiful.
And
beautifully
played. Puts it in for Coman to finish.
Yeah.
What a move by Zakaria Bentato. He is the current champion of Belgium and he's looking to add one more trophy to his already filling up quite nicely that resume of his.
Oh man, in the last phase of the game, and Wesley Campana is a bit frustrated though, but he has shown some beautiful skills. So Campana now is the man who just have to accept his loss.
Definitely.
And now clears his lines again.
Get a sip of water, maybe empty his bladder.
Yeah, just accept
you
can lose
square
again.
One.
Absolutely.
Back to the drawing board and just come back in the second match. Harder, faster, stronger, better.
Absolutely.
And he could very well still beat this. He could very well still push this to a third.
But Zakaria played really strong, really patient,
definitely.
A bit
amazing.
Different than his last games here at Anderlecht.
Yeah.
Just keep waiting all out. Just It all started with his first chance inside post, and then a few minutes later, there was the goal for Vidal.
Yeah.
And then if the third goal was pure magic, of course.
Pure magic, definitely.
The nice cross, the assist, and then the goal. Yeah, that was won by the book, as we say it.
Yeah, Koeman put it through really nicely.
Yeah.
And I'm anxious to see if he can put any more on the table in the second match coming up.
Yeah,
because
absolutely.
Wesley Campana will definitely be doing some changes, maybe, I suppose.
Yeah, both players will play in the same kits, in the same outfit. That means that red and white, the Bayern Munich home kit, is the kit. Oh, yeah, that was a beautiful goal.
Hammered it.
Hammered it. Yeah, that was a beautiful goal of Ribéry. But that means that Zakaria will play in red and white. Wesley Campana will play in the black of Bayern Munich. And he looks confident. He just nods his head a little bit to his fans. Yeah, you guys, I got this. Yeah. I know what I'm able to do.
Did you see the celebration on that third goal?
Yeah.
Jumping up to the crowd.
Yeah,
waving.
That was nice.
That's
that
the
was
experience
nice.
Of an international player, because he's played in Guadeloupe as well. He
yeah,
came third in that tournament.
Yeah, tournament, right,
that
third.
Chica Games Masters tournament.
Right.
International Masters Cup. Mm-hmm. And he came in third, so... That also speaks of his class, of his talent.
Absolutely.
And I'm he's showing it once again in Belgium.
Yeah, I'm just watching. Oh, there was Ulreich again, but Neuer is going to defend the goal. And both players will use the same system again. So that means four defenders, two defending midfielders, three offensive midfielders,
but
and
why
one striker.
Why Costa instead of Müller on the side of Wesley Campana? Because in FIFA, Müller is really still the very best choice up there. Or maybe Ribéry, of course. But
yeah,
Ribéry
but
is
lots
in
of
the
players just choose for Costa.
Yeah.
And Müller, yeah, they call him the German Luftwaffe, right? Because he's very good with his head.
Yeah, definitely. He scores so many goals. It already for the past 10 years, he's been scoring each season. And only last season was a little bit less.
No.
But still, this guy is a striker out and out.
And I'm very curious if he shows his ducky walk, you know. He says, yeah, I'm just walking here like a duck. Campana is ready. And I think Bentato, too, the Imperator, as his nickname, his online nickname is. That's a bit confusing, though, for people who don't follow esports a lot. You got their birth names, but you got their gaming names. Now here, look at the atmosphere there in the shadow of the Constant van der Stok. People having a great time here at the open fan day of Anderlecht. And just sitting in the sun watching this nice FIFA game on big screens. But for the players, it is not fun. It is pure business. It is winning or losing. Oh, that is a bit confident there. That's on the goal line. Manuel Neuer just takes it away from his attacker.
Good stuff,
yeah.
Zakaria came away with a scare there, but right now he should be shaken away.
Is it a bit provocative, maybe, of Zakaria?
Well, perhaps. But I think Wesley Campana went for it from the get-go, straight off the kickoff, trying to get some danger in and maybe catch Zakaria off guard. But there's no catching Zakaria off guard. He's always focused.
If you become Anderlecht Esports, you'll get a full contract, you get full medical guidance, you get full professional guidance. And I know this club, what they do, they want to do it best. And here is the first offensive, the first attack maybe from Campana.
Oh, no.
And then he suddenly changed his mind, for example. He just had to go walk through and take the shot. I mean, that would be a nice signal to Zakaria Bentato, who maybe feels a bit comfortable winning the first game so easy. No, not easily, but with a two-goal difference, that's a big win.
And well-deserved as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
He should have maybe one pass too many on that attack by Wesley Campana.
Yeah, one pass too many,
Right
yeah,
now, he's still going for it. And look at that. He's pushed one through, and it's Alaba on the flank. And he can put it in for Lewandowski to convert. Can't convert. Can't get the second chance as well. With a great sliding tackle by Zakaria. But Zakaria really needs to change pace here now.
Zakaria here with Bernard. It was perfect defending. But it's the second time that Zakaria got under pressure deep on his own turf. I mean, he has to defend a little bit more than this. But that's a nice skill from Ribéry. But yes, sometimes it dies in beauty, as we say it, up north.
Oh, definitely.
That was also very confident. Zakaria Bentato is just playing a bit. Maybe it's a bit provocative.
Cheeky.
Yeah, it's a bit cheeky.
Yeah.
But Wesley Campana is coming closer and closer.
I was going to say, most of the plays on the half of Zakaria Bentato right now for the past 15 minutes.
Yeah.
So maybe he shouldn't be so playful. Maybe he shouldn't be so cheeky. He should just be smart, casual, business-like, and just Sanchez put it to bed before Campana does this, because that's what's going to happen if you play with fire. You're going to get burned, and that's exactly what happened right now. Wesley Campana does not mess about and makes him pay for it. Zakaria Bentato, back to the drawing board.
Absolutely, and then that ties the score, not in goals, but in winning points. And if the score stays like this, we're going to get a third match, right?
Definitely, yeah. The 25-year-old pediatric from Limburg
has pushed
himself back on the board with this 1-0 advantage. And then some great defending there, just bothering him enough not to be able to get through the ball.
Yeah,
and
he just
Wesley Campana
has to
once
do
again
it.
In possession here on the right flank, trying to find a room for a move with Philipp Lahm, usually the captain, but after this season he will be finished with Bayern Munich. So right now the band is on the arm of, I think, Arturo Vidal. And look at those combinations. Zakaria Bentato, and he knows he has to make this one count. And that's exactly what he does. Robert Lewandowski once again on the score sheet, but this time at the other end of the pitch. Great
move. He just hold the ball a little bit back, man. That shows skills on maximum pressure. Yeah. We can see here the replay.
Yeah.
Look, just hold, wait it, and then want to make sure that his shot would count.
Yeah. First
one
touch,
all.
So important.
Yeah, first that's very important. And he knows you got to face Manuel Neuer. I mean, one of the best goalies also of this game, of course. Yeah, but that showed a little bit of class. I mean, you got so much space, but still you hold.
Yeah.
You choose, you pick your corner, and
keep
then you
cool,
strike.
Double tap, long side of the goal, and it goes in.
To stay so calm, that is pure class. So 1-1, Zakaria Bentato is going to the semis if the score stays like this. But I still believe in the chances of Wesley Campana playing in the black and the red and white for Zakaria Bentato. I think if he survives this quarterfinal, Bentato got heaps of trust and faith in his own skills, I guess.
Definitely, yeah, of course. If you become champion at some point, you know that you can do it. And you might be up there with the greats, but once you get that gold medal with all the great players there, you know that you're one of them. You know that you're the top dog, and you will have the confidence going into any tournament. That's exactly what is on display here today. Zakaria Bentato, like a fish in water, feels like there's something to be gained from this tournament. Feels like there's something to be gotten.
Yeah.
More than just a role as a cardboard figure on the pitch. And right now he's playing in his strikers. Well, he's trying to. He's trying to find space for the final pass. And here it comes, finally onto Lewandowski, who squares for Müller. Müller can't reach it. And right now Campana is in possession. Campana, who dominated possession for the first 15 minutes of the match, right now going into the last 15 minutes of the match, he needs to change pace because Zakaria Bentato is back on the scoreboard and back in focus, it seems.
Yeah, we're going to the closing phase of this first half of the second leg. 1-1 is the score. Two times Lewandowski. Campana struck first, and then just 2 minutes later, a beautiful attack with Lewandowski at the end of it. Squares. Oh, that's a beautiful aerial assist. Oh, that is such a shame. Wesley Campana was out of reach of that ball, but still Alaba in the center, because he's playing in the center. Yeah, that was pretty good. I mean, an aerial assist, an aerial through ball is very hard to defend.
We haven't seen much of those just yet,
no.
But we've seen some headed goals. From corners, we've seen one that got cleared off the line by Ramos in the Neander match. But
by Marcelo.
It was Stefano Pina with the almost goal.
Yeah.
But then again, he got plenty later on, scoring 8 in that same match. So, right now, though, looking at Zakaria Bentato at work, it's like it's becoming more and more predictable that this is his match to be had.
Yeah, I think so, too, because he plays, stays calm now here with Lewandowski. Has choices. Then Sanchez, who's playing a very crucial rebound role, gets up the ball in the line. And that is the signal for half time. 1-1. And Zakaria Bentato doesn't seem to be very happy, I saw.
Definitely, no. He started sitting back, even though he's still in the lead. He's still in the driver's seat. But he's he's looking at the crowd. Maybe there's someone in there. Maybe someone supporting him. I think his brother.
No, maybe it's my mother-in-law. I mean, I usually look like that when I see her.
Yeah,
no, that's of course. No, that's it. Not a very nice joke. Oh, oh, yeah, she's streaming as well. So
I know
we
what
get
you
home
mean.
Later.
It's like
no
an escape
pancakes
room, man,
for me.
When I go there. My wife gets the car keys,
yeah,
puts
absolutely.
It in her purse. Yeah. It's like the escape room.
Yeah,
I can't absolutely. Get out for 2 hours at least.
No, you can't get out for life. That's called marriage. No. I'm just joking around.
Yeah,
anyway, Zaccaria Bentato, he wasn't happy, but Wesley Campana, he already did it, but that was a bit of a punishment goal because Zaccaria Bentato was a bit too easy in the opening phase of the first half.
Yeah.
But still, if you see with how much speed he crosses the pitch, for example, this is a shame. But if that through ball was through, then the pitch was open.
Yeah, definitely.
A
lot of space to work with then, but not enough quality to take it over the top this time. Or maybe it's the defending of Campana.
Yeah, it is. Renato Sanchez there. And Lewandowski again with a quick foul. Oh. Yeah, this is pretty neat play from Zaccaria Bentato. A bit lucky though, but still. Sanchez, yes. Fans Ribéry, Robben then maybe. Oof. And there, Campana closes the door and finds his way through on the flank. Full speed now from Costa. There he is, Costa again, not Müller. And Lewandowski now with the ball for Wesley Campana.
Yeah, Wesley Campana, who prefers Costa over Müller. It's a different case for Zaccaria Bentato, but then again, Müller hasn't shown himself to be decisive for this match just yet. But still, Zaccaria Bentato has the upper hand in this matchup. It is all on the line right here, right now. It's the quarterfinals at our Royal Sporting Club Anderlecht, and whoever wins this will have a bigger chance of being the official Anderlecht player than the other by a mile, of course, and going towards that €600 check. Which
and
is ready for the winner.
You're the ambassador of Anderlecht with behavior that suits such a role. So not only your gameplay is very important and your strategic decision making, but still, yeah, the role you fulfill for Anderlecht. I mean, it is a huge responsibility, of course, and these players know that. Well, we're looking now at Campana, but he doesn't reach the penalty area of Zaccaria Bentato. But the pressure is high, and that's good to see. I think Wesley's playing more offensive because he's really putting the pressure on the build-up of Zaccaria Bentato. But now, with Bernat, he has found some space because Zaccaria plays with Müller on the same position, and Wesley plays with Costa.
Yeah. Other than that, there's not much difference between these two.
Same speakers. Systems.
They both got Ribéry and Robben in the middle and on the right, and well, of course, Vidal is a shoe-in. For the center position on the pitch. Oh, Wesley Campana with a big chance.
Oh,
combines
that was a big
it through. And smashed wide by Manuel Neuer. What a big chance for Wesley. And you can see in his face that he's very disappointed with that. Look at that.
He blows a bit with his lips. Know that the pressure is on.
Yeah.
I think those two players we're having now, Zaccaria Bentato and Wesley Campana, pay hugely respect to each other. You can
definitely
see that in the play. You can see that in their faces.
Yeah. And it's weird to say, but the 21-year-old Zaccaria Bentato is the more experienced player when it comes to tournaments. He's been playing ever since 2009, casually, and 2015 for when it comes to tournaments. And Wesley Campana, in 2011 he started playing FIFA already, but only since the end of 2016 he started playing tournaments. And then he quickly caught the eye of XOP Gaming, which he is representing right now, with his great, great results. Third in the FIFA Masters Cup and 32 of the world in June in the Weekend League.
Yeah,
so he's a rising star of Belgian FIFA.
If you want to explain that to people who haven't got many experience with those with this game, FIFA 17, who don't know what the Weekend League is, how big is this achievement, being number 32 of the world? How many players participate on the Weekend League?
That's
millions.
That's huge. That millions, yeah, millions
worldwide.
Playing. And they have to play 40 games each weekend and get as close
Robben
to 40
with a
wins
cheeky shot,
as possible. And of course, if you end up number 32 in the world, that means you've won 39 or 40 games. And that only a few other players were better in terms of making goals or
that's worldwide, man. And it's unbelievable what an achievement that is of Wesley Campana on his 25th year. Now we look at Zaccaria Bentato is playing his favorite game, A lot of positions close to each other, a lot of players close to each other. And then passing it all around, delicately touching the ball. But Campana, yeah, he just had a big chance, and usually that is a goal. But now you have to deal with Manuel Neuer, and he just took the ball off the line. Yeah. And Campana wasn't so close in this match until that moment.
Yeah, Bentata once again in possession. He lives close to here, he lives in Brussels. So if he were to be eliminated, it's not far walking home. Walking distance maybe.
Crying maybe then in the rain.
Yeah, but it doesn't look anything like that, because right now he's been dominating this tournament so far, like he dominated the qualifier as well with over 256 competitors.
Yeah.
With exactly that number there in the Constant van der Stok Stadium. And
that's a bit sloppy there.
Yeah, and Zakaria showed he was a big favorite to go all the way. Wesley showed it as well, but right now Zakaria has the upper hand. Zakaria working towards another attacking move. He could very well put this to bed. He could very well hammer the final nail into the coffin. That is the coffin of Wesley Campana's FIFA career today. But, oh, right now, Zakaria Bentato. Beautiful pass onto Renato Sanchez. Couldn't get there in time. And right now, with the counter, Wesley Campana.
Yeah,
a lot of space
good.
To work with. Oh, what a sliding tackle.
Yeah, from Alaba. Alaba
quite
usually
a
is a wing back, but now he plays center back. And I think a player is injured, though. No. Campana just goes through. No, loses the ball to Zakaria Bentato. Both players one goal away from the semis. Actually, this score means that Zakaria go to the semi-final. Campana only needs one. Maybe that one crucial goal is coming right now with Lewandowski. Twists and turns. Goes for the shot.
Oh!
And the goal. He does it in the 90th minute.
What a beauty.
Wesley Campana deserves here his third match. The third match. The decisive. It's unbelievable. This is pure quality. Because everybody, again with Robert Lewandowski, everybody thought that Campana's tournament was over. And then in the absolutely last minute of the game, he does it. We're going to get a third match. And the moral winner is Wesley Campana.
Yeah, but here we're going straight to penalties. We don't have time for the
third
match.
Okay, we're just going to get penalty kicks already. I'm sorry.
Here we go.
No third match. Penalty kicks.
It looked like he was on his way home, Wesley Campana. It looked like he was all over. He was standing in front of the gates of hell,
man.
He was looking down into the abyss. And somehow, he got the mental strength to fight back. Look at him. He's
this game's
What will Zakaria be doing right now?
Zakaria's, I don't know. Maybe he's taking a time out. Because he thought he was there. He thought, I'm going to play this semi-final against Stefano Pina. But then there was Lewandowski. And we're going to take the penalties, the dreadful penalties, to decide.
What is he thinking right now, Wesley? Look at him.
Yeah, I think he's the moral winner now.
Counting
of the two matches.
I mean, I guess.
This is FIFA 17 in optima forma.
He can't
right?
even believe it.
Yeah, we can't believe it. But still, he's sitting there on the chair, and he's not off this stage. Yeah, you can smile, Wesley. I mean,
oh, definitely.
You deserve that smile. With a beautiful goal in the last minute. It is a bit, of course, the German way. Well, okay. Then you play with Bayern Munich. This was a big chance for him.
Yeah.
With Costa.
I want to see that goal again. Oh, but
well, that goal was crucial. And Zakaria Bentato of Ego.
Here it comes. Look at
here
that.
Here it comes. Yeah, man.
Oh, wow. With the left foot of Robert Lewandowski. What a goal to finish it off.
Yeah, Gary Lineker, the presenter and the famous footballer from England, always says, football is a simple game, 11 against 11, and after 90 minutes, the Germans win. But this is unbelievable. Zakaria's still off stage, and we're going to take a little commercial break, and then we're going to take this penalty series between Zakaria Bentato and Wesley Campana. Who will reach the semi-final of this grand tournament? Who will be the first e-sporter of Anderlecht?
Okay. Ja, prima. Zo dacht.